In Man of Medan, players who found enough pieces of evidence to parse out what happened in 1947 unlock a set of comic books that tell the story in full. In Little Hope, if players are diligent enough to find all of the fake evidence about things that didn't happen, they'll unlock two comic books that are as baffling as they are pointless. Sadly, there are no comics in House of Ashes, so players never get to have a look at the story of the 1947 archaeological dig disappearance in full. Instead of the comic books, we're treated to a series of audio logs with montages that accompany them. While they're not as comprehensive as the comic books, at least we got a clear timeline of what happened in the backstory when the archaeological expedition met its unfortunate end. Or did we? What if Randolph was lying in his diary entry as an audio log? What if he did something that he very much wanted history to forget and created a false narrative in his journal to ensure that that happened? Here's what we're told about how Lady Bradshaw died. After locking away his wife, Randolph says that he found Lady Bradshaw, transformed into a vampire, feeding on Van Huyten's blood. She then attacked him and he stabbed her with a tent stake, piercing her chest and killing the parasite that was puppeteering her body. If we look for evidence to support this theory, however, we come up light, and in fact, all of the clues point in a very different direction. First off, let's take a look at the murder weapon. It's a tent stake, which seems like a strange thing to have at hand for the kind of sudden attack in self-defense that supposedly resulted in Lady Bradshaw's death. If this fight had happened back in the throne room, sure, that would make perfect sense. But here in the catacombs? No one is putting up a tent down here, or even securing a tarp or spotlight. So what was the tent stake doing there? Well, it doesn't make much sense as an item for Randolph to have randomly grabbed in a struggle. If Randolph, filled with rage and desperate to kill Lady Bradshaw, saw a spike lying around up in the throne room, it's absolutely something that he might have grabbed. There's no reason to suspect that Randolph carried a knife or gun out of habit, so the tent stake would absolutely serve as a perfect, improvised murder weapon. So now that we know that the murder weapon was likely brought into the catacombs by Randolph, for the purposes of killing Lady Bradshaw, but can we prove that Lady Bradshaw's death was a murder, rather than self-defense against a hungry vampire? Actually, we can, because Randolph's account of events, he found Bradshaw having murdered Van Huyten and then killed her in self-defense, doesn't hold up to scrutiny. Let's take a quick look at the three people who can get turned into vampires in the 2003 section of House of Ashes narrative. Here's Joey, here's Clarice, here's Rachel. What do all of them have in common? That's right, prominent fangs. Here's a vampire skull from years earlier. Note the missing teeth, where the parasite sets its fangs. While Mary's skull, here in the cell, doesn't have the highest resolution to her mouth, you can clearly see a row of solid teeth at the bottom and an interrupted row of teeth at the top, with this indentation here representing where the vampire's fangs were. We know that the absolute first thing vampires do when they take over a dead body is pop the teeth out and set their fangs. Here's Clarice just minutes after being killed by the parasite. Here's Rachel immediately after being converted. You've seen Lady Bradshaw's body a number of times in this video. Did you notice it? Her mouth is completely full of perfect teeth. This alone proves that Lady Bradshaw was not a vampire when she died. She was a human when Randolph drove that stake into her heart. Her mouth proves it. Despite this, though, there was a vampire in the catacombs, one that bit into Van Huyten's neck and drained him dry. It was also likely a young enough vampire that it wasn't able to implant a new parasite into him, because he didn't get right back up. But if it couldn't have been Lady Bradshaw, and her lack of vampire fangs proves that it couldn't have been, then who did it? Here's what really happened on New Year's 1947. Just as he reports in his notes, Randolph stayed with his wife as she was killed by the parasite. Then, in a fit of despair, he stormed off on his own. While he was out of the room, Mary woke up as a vampire and went looking for food. She found Van Huyten in the catacombs and attacked him. Randolph hears the sound of Mary feeding and runs back to help, finding her draining the last of Van Huyten's blood. He overpowers Mary and drags her back to the cells, locking her inside. Then he goes looking for Lady Bradshaw up in the throne room, but doesn't find her. He does find a weapon, however, in the form of that spare tent stake. Meanwhile, Lady Bradshaw returns from searching either the pit or the ship beyond it, and finds the locked up Mary and Van Huyten's dead body. Before she can act on this new knowledge, Randolph finds her in the catacombs and confronts her. We can't guess how this interaction went, but it ended with Lady Bradshaw dead a stake jammed into her chest. His mind clear after his vengeance is complete, Randolph is shocked by the horror of what he's done, and lies to the rest of the expedition about what happened, going so far as to write a fake version of the events in his journal. Not just to protect himself, but also because he can't bear to have his beloved wife remembered as a killer, even if it was the vampire parasite that was responsible for her actions. So that's it. The murder mystery in House of Ashes has been solved. I wonder what secrets there are still left to uncover. I've been the Hidden Object Guru, thanks for watching. If you haven't already, please like and subscribe. If you'd like to see more from me, drop by the stream we do every night on YouTube and Twitch. Weekdays at 9 p.m. Eastern, weekends at noon Eastern. Special thanks to my patrons Marissa, Desire, Eduardo, Brian, and Joanne. If there's any topics you'd like to see covered in future videos, please mention them in the comments section. I'll see you back here for more Dark Pictures, but until then, au revoir.